The Occidental Mindoro Electric Cooperative blames regulatory red tape for the power crisis gripping the province. Omeco's board president asserts the power shortage is only artificial, triggered by the actions of the Energy Regulatory Commission, National Power Corporation, as well as power supplier Occidental Mindoro Consolidated Power Corporation, or OMCPC. According to Omeco, OMCPC had stopped delivering power due to a lack of a power-sharing agreement and a delay in the payment of subsidy from the NPC.
Yung sa ERC po, ang problema namin sa kanila, yung regulatory red tape nila sa approval ng mga PSA. At saka doon po sa hindi makatarungan, hindi makatao na penalty na inimpose sa Omeco. Yun pong sa NPC na problema namin, yung mga delay ng kanilang subsidy payments para sa OMCPC, para sa supplier namin, na nagiging dahilan naman para singilin po ng OMCPC ang aming ang penalty na ipinataw ng ERC. Yun pong Office of the President, sumulat na po yung isang MCO namin, sumulat na, nakarating na po yata sa Presidente. Pero siyempre, hindi naman po agad-agad yan maaayos. Ang nakikita po naming solusyon sana, para medyo makaalwan kami, magkailaw na kami, alisin po ng ERC yung ipinataw niya na hindi makatarungan talaga na penalty.
Occidental Mindoro was placed under a state of power crisis last week after suffering months of blackouts. A transport group is appealing to the Philippine government to allow jeepneys to serve their original routes ahead of in-person classes in November. The group, Liga ng Transportasyon at Mga Operator sa Pilipinas, says it will be convenient for students if they don't have to transfer rides to get to school. LTOP President Orlando Marquez Sr. notes many students are often tired from the commute. He also questions government's decision to add some 8,000 units for ride-hailing services to allegedly solve traffic woes. Another transport group composed of bus operators and drivers is also seeking a review of the route rationalization implemented by the Duterte administration. The group's executive director, Alex Yagis, says passengers have to pay more for transportation costs. And because routes were changed, many of the loading and unloading points were also adjusted. This led to commuters taking multiple trips instead of just one ride. Yagis hopes the issue will be tackled in a scheduled meeting with transport regulators this week.
Mga ruta na yan ay pinag-aralan mabuti yan ng mga nakaraang mga administrasyon para maserbisyuhan ang ating mga kababayan galing probinsya. Ang mga universidad, hindi naman basta-basta ililipat mo yan, maililipat yung kanilang mga lugar, pasilidad nila.
Transport officials vow to fast-track payments to bus operators participating in the government's free ride program. That's after finally meeting with the operators who claim they haven't received any pay for 2 months. President Marcos had extended the EDSA Bus Carousel program until December this year. But the Transport Department admits it has to seek help from the Budget Department since the program costs 10 million pesos per day.
We are insured at this point na kaya naming paabutin more or less ng August. And we are requesting for the budget in coordination na po si Secretary Bautista with the Department of Budget and Management.